On desktop, just double click on Tally ERP9 icon. It will be opening Tally ERP9 software. You will be getting a startup screen. On that, we have to go to work in education mode. Enter. Then the company name will be displayed towards left side of the screen. And on which financial year you are there and on which date you will be there. On towards right side, we can find out gateway of Tally, which is very important menu. Whatever you are going to do, you should be written back to your gateway of Tally. It is just like a home menu. Now today we are going to discuss about company features, under that statutory and taxation. So on this screen of gateway of Tally, we has to press F11 key from keyboard, or we can use F11 features with mouse. Then company features will be appearing. Under that, the first option is accounting features. The second one is inventory features. And the third one is statutory and taxation. Today, we are here to discuss about statutory and taxation, how it will be implemented by companies or individuals in Tally. So on this statutory and taxation, you have to press enter key. It will be showing some tax topics to you. Under that, the first option is enable goods and service tax, which is also called as GST. It should be placed to S. Enter. Then set by alter GST details. Even place this one into also S. When you press enter key, it is dividing a small window like this. And this is very important screen where you have to provide all the GST information to the system. Now it is asking for state on or in which state you are. You have to select the state name there. Right now we are from Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam. So I'm selecting state. By giving this state, we will be in a position to allot GST numbers. Now system will ask me registration type. GST registration is of two types. Either I can pay my tax on monthly basis, which is called as regular, or I can pay my tax quarterly, which is called as composition. If I select regular here, in the periodicity of GSTR1, it is showing monthly. Just press backspace, go to registration type. If you select their composition, automatically one more option is being asked. Press yes there. Automatically it will be converted to composition scheme. So better to always, you should be in a position to pay tax monthly. Now when you are selecting composition, you cannot collect a tax or you cannot pay tax on your total turnover. You have to pay tax to the department. So again, backspace, registration type, always select regular. Enter. GST applicable from. Actual GST has been implemented from 2017, July 1st. But here, on which date your company is starting, give that date. Now it is asking GSTIN, goods service tax identification number. Now this GST number is a combination of characters and variables of 15 digits and numbers. Out of that, the first two will indicate state code. So 37 is Andhra Pradesh GST code. For examples, 36 is Telangana state code. 27 is Maharashtra state code. 33 is Tamil Nadu state code. So the GST contains 15 characters and variable number. Out of that 15, the first two indicates you the state. The next, the next 10 numbers starting from A, S, D, F, K, 1, 2, 3, 4, A. These are the next 10 numbers, combination of characters and numbers will indicate the PAN number of the individual or PAN number of the company. The PAN number can be, where PAN stands for permanent account number. The PAN can be in the name of a person or the PAN can be in the name of a company. First, we discuss about the PAN number. If it is in case of a person, what will be there? If the PAN card is in the name of a person, the fourth character will be P, where P stands for individual. And the fifth character will be surname of the person. Okay. Or if the PAN card is in the name of a company or a firm, if it is in the name of a company, here the fourth character will be C and the company's starting letter. Or if the PAN card is in the name of a firm, the fourth character will be F, which indicates firm, and the fifth character will be starting letter of the company. Or if you are a joint stock company or you are Hindu undivided family, the fourth character indicates H, which is Hindu undivided family, and the name of the person. So like this, without PAN card, you don't get GST number. So we treat our PAN card is in the name of a company. So the fourth character will be firm. The fifth character will be company starting letter. Then any four numbers and ends with a character. See, please take only 10 numbers and variables. Count it, you will be getting 10, which indicates your PAN. The first two digits indicate state code. Next 10 digits or characters indicate your PAN. And the last 3-digit characters, it can be 1ZN, it can be 1Z any number. In the last character, we can give number or anything. Or it can be 2Z number or character. It indicates the GST code and Z indicates Vizag. So we are providing 1ZN. So this is the combination of PAN, state code and GST coding, which is called as goods, service tax, identification number. These will be totally 15 variables and characters, where the first two indicates state code, next 10 indicates PAN card, and the last 3 indicates GST coding. Press enter there. Now, you are selected here regular. In regular, you can pay your tax monthly or you can pay quarterly. But the best option is monthly. So select monthly here. Next, e-way bill. This is very important feature where GST brought into market. E-way bill is nothing but to whom we are selling. Here we means a company. To whom we are selling, if the invoice value crosses 50,000. Then we has to prepare e-way bill by providing our company name, GST number, our invoice details to the purchaser. And the purchaser GST number, purchaser details. So if the invoice value crosses 50,000, whether it is local, interstate, we has to provide e-way bill. So the limit is 50,000. Now coming to enable tax liability on advance receipts. Commonly in any business of trading, first we do credit sale. After credit sales, we'll be giving them some time for 30 days. Later they will pay us. The same way on our purchases, we will give them, they will be giving some time to us. We'll be paying after 45 days. But this is quite different. Without selling, we will be receiving some advance from customer. That advance is totally liable for tax. Then we has to put this option into yes. For example, we are a contractor or we are in a service sector. We got a service from ICICI Bank, for example. Take that we are in interior designing business. ICICI Bank offered us to provide interior designing to their office, and the work contract is for 3 months, and the work contract value is of 5 lakhs. Once you complete the total work there, then only we are in a position to raise the invoice for them. Then only they will pay us. But in between, they can issue us or they can release some funds in form of advances. Whatever the advance we are receiving, it is liable to pay tax as per the tax rate. Now, enable tax liability on reverse charge, which is also called as RCM, reverse charge mechanism. If I want to sell, I should be a registered dealer, then I can be selling to a consumer or customer, or I can sell to any company or individual who is having GST number. So in selling, if I'm selling to GST holder, B2B will be there. Or if I'm selling to any consumer or customer, B2C will be there. But if I want to sell, I has to purchase. Now, if I want to purchase, I has to purchase from GST holder. Then the purchase will be called as B2B purchases, means from whom I am purchasing, he is also a GST holder and myself also a GST holder. Then no problem, there will be no reverse charge. I can claim ITC. But if I am purchasing from an unregistered dealer or from a person who is not having GST, I will be getting the material and I will be selling to customers or GST holders. But when I'm purchasing, on my purchases, there is no GST. So I can't claim ITC. And I'm purchasing from an unregistered dealer who is not having GST number. Then we have to use this option into yes. And reverse charge mechanism gives us option on whatever the purchases we are making from unregistered dealer, we have to pay tax on that total purchase value, and we has to pay to department. Now, set by alter GST rate details. Right now, put this option into yes, but in future, whenever we require, we'll make into yes. Sir, when it will be useful? Right now in the market, we are having slab rates 28%, 18%, 12%, 5%, 3%, zero. Central government has declared all the items, goods into this slab. For example, in today markets, some items are there in 18%. In future, GST Council can convert the 18% items to 12% or 5 or can increase up to 28. So at that time, suppose you are in your business, you entered an item name and given a tax rate of 12% or 18 and you are doing from April to September. On September, GST Council has changed the 18% item to 5%. So if you alter the item rate and if you give 5% directly, from April to till date, everything taxes will convert into 5%. No, it is wrong. From April to September, the tax rate will be 12 or 18, what previously we given. But from September, on which date the council has been updated, the rate, put this option into yes. Select the item name. Select the item name. Then you can allot the tax rate change with the date also. So put this option into yes. Taxable. Previously, it will be, for example, suppose 28 will be there. Now you want to convert into 5%. It will ask in the date, na? So there you don't give 1-4 April. You just give the September date. Okay, it is for your example. Enter. GST classifications. So 90% put this GST rate options into no. And the GST classification should be in yes. Now, what is the use of GST classifications? For example, if I'm running a shop of different brands of biscuits, different brands of chocolates or ice creams, I'll be having some 5 to 6 groups, 5 to 6 brands of all. But tax rate is not depend on the brand or the category. How many brands you have in the market of biscuits? For biscuits, tax rate will be there. How many brands of chocolates or ice creams are there? For brand, we don't have any tax. For individually chocolate or for ice creams, we'll be having tax. So if my business is like that, then I no need to create item-wise tax rate because whatever the item I'm using, biscuit or chocolate or ice creams. So whatever can be the brand, tax will be same. Then provide LUT bond, which is LUT stands for letter of undertaking. Commonly, everybody knows about SEZ, Special Economy Zones. If we do business with them, we'll be not paying any tax from whatever the purchases we are making from SEZ. At that time, we have to provide them LUT. So at the time of registration of GST for a company, we should be in a position to register regarding letter of undertaking for SEZ units. Enter. Enter. Then right now there is no VAT, there is no excise duty, there is no service tax. Totally has been removed and totally has been converted to GST. Then come to PAN number. Whatever the PAN number you given in GSTIN, you has to provide the same PAN number. ASDF means firm, K means company starting letter 1234A. And this is corporate identification number. For example, you take State Bank of India or Apollo Hospitals or HSBC Bank, TCS, Tata Consultancy Services, or Infosys. Don't think these are the companies will be only in India. These are having branches in all over the world. For example, I'm having State Bank of India in Delhi, Hyderabad, and Vizag. The same way in USA also we'll be having State Bank of India. The same. So number of branches in different states and different places across the world, they will be identified with corporate identification number. Enter. So this is the topic. Today we are discussing about statutory and taxation. Hope you can understand very easily. Thanks a lot. We are from Data Pro Computers, Dwarka Nagar branch, Vishakhapatnam. We are the best training institute for IT sector. Thank you.